Maria, and today I'm going to help you understand the ins and outs of a URL. What is a URL and how does it work? A URL is essentially a unique address that will lead to a specific website when entered into a web browser. It's what makes it easy to share web pages or YouTube videos like this one with your friends. Without URLs, you would have no way to separate one page from the other 64 billion web pages on the internet. In this video, I will explain what URLs are, break down the individual building blocks of how it works, cover what a good URL looks like for SEO purposes and more. But before we get too far, I want to let you know that there will be links to more resources in the video's description. And remember, subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content. Now, what is a URL? A URL, or Uniform Resource Locator, is an address that helps your web browser locate a specific web page, picture, file, or other resource. Your browser takes the address, translates the domain name to the IP address of the server, and the rest of the URL shows the path to the specific file on that server. A URL leads to a specific file or page, while domain name is the general address to the whole website or server. To look at an example of a URL, all you need to do is look at the web address field at the top of your browser, right underneath your tabs. Sometimes your browser might hide the HTTPS until you double-click the field. The first part of a URL identifies which protocol the server and web page use to transfer data to your computer. HTTP stands for Hypertext Transfer Protocol. HTTPS stands for Hypertext Transfer Protocol Secure and is a more secure encrypted protocol for transferring data. Google Chrome will show you that a site uses HTTPS with the lock symbol, symbolizing a secure website. If a site uses HTTP, depending on the browser, website, and operating system, you may see an attention mark or it may automatically open a prompt that warns visitors. Not only is that a bad look for your site, but using HTTP can negatively affect your website's rankings for Google keywords. Google has officially confirmed that they use it to decide where your page should rank in the search results. If you're still using HTTP for your WordPress site, we've got a detailed guide for migrating your site from HTTP to HTTPS. The domain name is what helps the browser find your web server in the first place, using the DNS, or domain name system. Put simply, DNS helps a browser translate a domain name into the actual IP address of the web server connected with it. Without the DNS, we would have to surf the web by sharing chains of numbers like this. Read our guide to learn more about what DNS is and how exactly it connects domain names to web servers. The path is any part of the URL that comes after the domain name. At first, the URL directly represented the file and folder structure of your server. So if you had to reach that file, you could follow that exact path with your FTP client to delete or edit it. For example, if the path looks like this, the structure would be the same on your server. If you used FTP or a file manager to look at it, it would look identical. But these days, most websites are built with the CMS. CMSs rely on the server architecture to connect a normal-looking URL to a query string that will generate the right page. That's how WordPress permalinks work, and why this URL leads to this page even though we have no folder called blog, or file named what is a URL on our server. If this sounds complicated, and you don't quite get it yet, don't worry. We're going to be going over WordPress permalinks here in a bit. The query string is the part that follows the question mark, and it can include variables that communicate with the PHP on that page to impact the visitor's experience. For example, for WordPress, the P variable is short for post and indicates which post WordPress is going to show on that page. Without permalinks to make the URL more appealing, a WordPress post would only be accessible through URLs like this. You would need to specify the post ID to WordPress directly to get to the page you wanted. URLs like like this are no longer a huge concern for social sharing, as most social media sites now include previews and meta titles for shared links. But this type of URL can negatively impact the SEO of your website or blog. UTM parameters are different from query strings that provide a variable for your site's CMS or web app. Instead of directly affecting the visitor's experience, they communicate with your analytics software. For example, Google Analytics. These UTM tags track where visitors came from to analyze campaign performance. You can use them to indicate which platform, campaign, and even specific ad sent to visitor. Some advertising platforms automatically generate parameters to store data about visitors. The anchor is anything that comes behind a hash sign. It's a page-specific link that leads to a specific part of a page. This URL will take you to the anatomy of a URL part of this page because it's an anchor link or jump link to the ID of that specific subheading. To use anchor links, you need to add an ID to the HTML tag that you want to link to. In this case, the actual code for the headline of this H2 section looks like this in plain HTML. You can also add one manually to headers in the Gutenberg editor in WordPress by expanding in the advanced section on a heading block. At Kinsta, we don't bother manually adding IDs to all subheaders. Instead, we use a plugin that generates a table of contents and jump links automatically for every article. The plugin creates a span around relevant headings with the ID, saving us the trouble of manually adding it. To learn more about how you can set this up on your WordPress site, read our guide on anchor links. Including a www in your URL used to be a standard for all websites on the internet. That's not the case anymore. You may have even noticed that our website, kinsta.com, doesn't include www in the URL. The three W's are an optional part of a URL. By default, Google Chrome and many other browsers don't even show it anymore. The redirects render it relevant to the user experience. There can be some pros and cons to each option, depending on your company size and goals. Read more about choosing between a www domain and a non-www domain to make your decision. If you want to add or drop the www, we've already covered how to change your URL to include or remove www in WordPress. We briefly touched on this already, but with a CMS like WordPress, the URL path doesn't represent the real path through existing folders and files on your server. Instead, WordPress uses PHP and MySQL to generate pages based on query strings included in the URL like this. Prettier permalinks, like the one for this blog post, rely on an Apache or Nginx rewrite function to tie a URL to a relevant WordPress permalink with the post ID. Thankfully, you don't have to understand your server ecosystem or how to do this manually to make any changes to your URL. You can handle it all within WordPress, as long as your server environment is set up correctly. If you set it to plain, your posts will only be accessible if you use links with the post ID variable. Most WordPress sites avoid this for SEO reasons. A random number string can't include a matching word and is less clickable than a link that makes sense. Instead, most sites use a structure that includes a blog title or a variant of it in the URL. WordPress's auto-generated slugs and permalinks aren't always ideal because sometimes they look like something like this. It's simply too long and not ideal for sharing or SEO either. So for SEO and sharing purposes, you can set a custom slug and permalink for each post and page. Just expand the permalink section in the right-hand sidebar when creating any page or post. For SEO purposes, you want to keep a slug clean and short, without unnecessary filler words or adjectives. Learn more about optimizing these settings in our ultimate guide to WordPress permalinks. If you move an old page or post, you might wonder if there's any way to ensure you can still get the traffic and links from the old URL. For example, you might update the slug by year from 2019 to 2020. Change your domain name, or any number of things. Luckily, redirects are easy to set up. You can set up redirects from your hosting dashboard, like our custom-developed My Kinsta, or a generic cPanel. The status code indicates to the browser and search engine crawlers the status of the redirect. 301 means the redirect is permanent, that you have moved the post to a new location. It's ideal for SEO as it passes most of the original authority and link juice the old article had to the new one. There are many ways to set up a WordPress redirect, including using plugins or even editing your server environment manually. If a URL is extra long, it may be tempting to use a URL shortener when using it in social media posts or emails. If you're linking to a specific part of a post with a long anchor, or want to hide your UTM parameters, it's a good idea. Here's a few rules to follow. Only use reputable URL shorteners like bit.ly or tinyURL without any advertising breaks or slow loading times. Any ads or added time mean fewer users stick around to visit the page. If a URL is already short and makes sense, like kinsta.com/wordpress-hosting, sharing the original version is better. Never use shortened URLs for hyperlinks, as a URL is already hidden behind the link text anyway. A shortened URL is mostly useful for sharing on social media, emails, or in videos. Most SEO experts consider a shortened URL to have no negative impact on your SEO or search rankings. If you're looking to boost your site's organic traffic and beat out your competition, then we have the perfect ebook for you. Download our free ultimate guide to SEO ebook to gain access to the 50 plus tips we use to grow our own organic traffic by more than 123% year after year. Thank you so much for watching. If you found this video helpful, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell for more tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.